Hi guys, my name is Joji and welcome to my channel. So I hope you all are doing good. Me too. Today it's really good day here in Belgium. We got around 37 degrees Celsius today, so it's a bit high for the average Belgian summer days. So we are enjoying the day today. And by the way, I'm here with my another video. So that would be another car review. And what? Yeah, I know what you people are thinking, because you may be thinking, why the hell he's speaking in English, right? Because, okay, I'll explain you that. Because, you know, many of my friends, many of my viewers are not from Kerala. That means they don't understand a word in Malayalam. So many of them have asked me, requested me, if I could do video in English at least. Because there are many friends who are French-speaking friends from here in Belgium and from France. So even they have asked me, why don't you do videos at least in English, so that they can understand a little bit from that, because they don't speak Malayalam, they don't understand a word in Malayalam. So I have decided, okay, I'll give it a try. So today I'll be doing the video in English. Please let me know whether it's good, or how you feel, whether I should continue doing videos in English, or I should go back to my Malayalam videos. So please let me know in the comment box. And without wasting time, let's jump into our video. Today we have got another beautiful car, that is Toyota CHR, the all new 2020 Toyota CHR Hybrid. So guys, here it is, the really beautiful and futuristic looking Toyota CHR. Because this design, there are many people, they don't like this design, but I personally do like this one, because you know, it's not a normal car design that we see everywhere. It's really different. You know, you can see the whole design. Okay, we may be a bit confused, because we may think that what is this exactly, in which category this car comes. You know, it is a coupe, or it's an SUV, or what it is. But it's basically an SUV, but without the normal SUV things, we can say. Okay, so first we see about the external design of this car. The first thing that grab your attention is, of course, the Toyota logo with a blue background that indicates it's a hybrid vehicle. There are beautiful piano black inserts just above the logo, which extends up to the sides. Unlike other cars, it does not have much grille area, but it does have a large air dam in the lower front part, which is also in contrasting black color. The most beautiful thing is the complete LED headlight cluster. The DRLs and main headlight is gracefully integrated, and that goes well in hand with the aggressive look of the car. The design gets more unconventional and interesting on the side profile. We have a hybrid badge just below the A-pillar. It has got beautiful 18-inch alloy wheels. This car has dual-tone body paint, which is white and black in this case. We have the option to get in many other bright colors like yellow, red, blue or green, but all combined with black. It has got slanting roofline towards the C-pillar, and the window line meets the roof at the C-pillar. So, naturally, the rear window area is so narrow. At first glance, you may not find the handlebar for rear doors, because it's almost like hidden in the C-pillar.
Okay, so here we are at the backside of the CHR. So first thing you see is the spoiler. It has got a spoiler with brake lights here, and the whole black finish in this part. And we come here, it's the Toyota logo, and of course the hybrid badge and the Toyota CHR badge. And the tail lamp cluster, it's completely LED tail lamp. And I'll show you one more thing, the indicators are now flowing indicators. Let me just show you. It has got a flowing indicator. That is a new update to Toyota CHR's 2020 version. Before it was normal indicators, now we have got a funky flowing indicator. Okay, here the boot space is really good. It's 377 liters of boot space, and it's really convenient for transporting the things or our luggages. But the only small problem that I found is the loading lip. It's a fairly big loading lip. But they have given 4 tethering points and two hooks over here. That is a small light. And we can, of course, extend the boot space by folding the rear seats. But it's not flat surface, completely flat. But I can show you that. We can remove this cover. And of course, from here, we can fold the rear seats in 60-40 manner. But here you can see it's not flat. So though we get a fair amount of loading space, but it's not flat, but of course it's manageable. So now we'll see about the engine specification. So this thing is a petrol vehicle with a battery, that means hybrid, of course, and it has got a 1.8 liter petrol, and again powered with an electric motor that is fitted under the rear seats. Okay, now we will see inside. While inside, we notice the unconventional exterior design continues inside too. It has got an all-black interior which gives a premium feel. Steering wheel is small and sporty with all necessary controls on it. The central meter console is basic with two large physical dials and a small screen in between with some of the important informations on it. Though the materials used are of good quality soft touch materials over the door pads and dashboards, there are some hard plastics on the lower parts of the doors and the central console. The highlight of the interior is, of course, the infotainment system with a big 8-inch touchscreen. There are some dedicated physical buttons on both sides of the screen, which is really handy while driving. At last, Toyota have come up with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay with this facelift model. Just below the screen, we have got the air vents and then the dual zone climate controls and heated seat controls. In the central console, we see the small gear lever for the 7-speed automatic CVT. Two cup holders are incorporated, one in front of the gear lever and the other behind the gear lever. We have a deep cubby space under the handrest where we find a 12 volt socket too. There is an USB port and a small shelf for cell phones just below the dash where the central console begins. While speaking about the safety features, this car has got almost all the bells and whistles. 7 airbags, blind spot monitoring, lane detection warning, pedestrian monitoring, auto emergency brakes, adaptive cruise control, real-time speed limit detection are some among them. Let me show you one more thing. Here you can see there is a small button, SOS button. Okay, you have to see this. There's this nice cap here so that we may not push that accidentally. If you want to really push the SOS button, we need to remove the cap, like in some kind of Air Force movies, like for activating the bomb. See that? And if we are in a state of distress or some we need assistance or something like that, is in case of emergency, we can just push this button and there'll be an operator responding to our calls, and we can say him whatever we need, like what is our situation, and they will respond accordingly. Or else, if we didn't respond at all, just we need to push it, and if we didn't respond, then also they will send the emergency personnel or emergency police or emergency people for our help. So here we are going to the back seat. We'll see how the space and all the practicality of the passenger side. So first of all, the handlebars are hidden, so we may be confused where is the handlebar exactly. So once we get used to it, it's okay. So yeah, the door opens not so wide, so the getting in will be a small problem for adults because there isn't much space here. So because it's so first of all, the legroom, it's okay, and the headroom is limited. Of course, you know, headroom is limited because of the slanting roof line. You can see my head is touching the roof line, the side roof. Okay, while inside the passenger side, I would say I would rather feel a bit claustrophobic because of the all black layout. Even the seats and interior, everything is black. And the window area is much less compared to other vehicles. So if for the adults, it may be okay because we can see, of course, we are big and we can see outside. But children, they may feel a bit claustrophobic because of the less window area. We have got here the cup holders. And one more thing, one more drawback here is we don't have any air vents for the back side. Even in the roof or here, we don't have any air vents. And otherwise, the seat is good. So here we have got ISOFIX points in the both side seats. The one more thing, there is a cap for the ISOFIX, but it comes off completely, so we may lose it. So we need to be careful. So I don't know why, because I think Toyota, especially for the CHR, they are a bit obsessed with the diamond designs. Because we can see a pattern of diamond designs everywhere in this car. You know, I'll show you here. When we enter, here are the door designs. Here, we have got some diamond kind of thing here. And here again, some diamond designs. Of course, again, the seats of diamond design. And in the roof line, see, there are again some diamonds over the roof, and again even in the back side, of course, here again the diamond design, the seats again, and of course here, see, just behind the seat belts, they have got again some diamond designs. I don't know why. The door pads, of course, and even in the speakers, the grill over the speaker, it's in the diamond design. I don't know if you can see in the camera, because it's, of course, it's a small bulges that looks like diamond design. So let's see, we are heading the road to find out how it drives. It is not a plug-in hybrid, but it uses a technology that enables the battery of the electric motor gets charged from the petrol engine on the go and even while braking. So when we start the car, the electric motor is working and it continues while we cruise in lower speeds. If we go more than about 50 kilometers an hour, the petrol engine kicks in automatically. And it's quite good for cruising speed, and of course for maneuvering it's quite good because of the good and light and small steering wheel. It's quite comfortable, and it's a comfortable seating position. Of course, the seats are really good. We can adjust in various positions, the seats and of course the steering wheel. So we get a good driving position, and the view here, it's good. And in the suspension, it's a bit in the firmer side, I think. But the road conditions here, it's okay. There is not much of potholes and everything in the road. So it's quite good for driving, and the corners, and it takes the corners really well, and we have the confidence. Okay, while we drive, we have the confidence. Even the automatic gearbox, it's quite responsive, and the steering wheel, it's also, it's really responsive, and I don't feel any flaws in that. And it's a fun car. It's a fun car to drive, I would say. And of course, you can see there is a speed detection warning. So it detects automatically the speed of the current speed limit in that road. And of course, it says if you are going over the limit, it indicates. The overall driving experience is quite good. Apart from the rear passenger seat, the secluded places, the front side, it's quite good. Even the driving position and everything is really good in this car. So that was about the all new 2020 CHR hybrid, and of course I didn't explain it in detail, but I think you have got an idea, overall idea about this new CHR hybrid. So I would recommend this car because for the driving experience, it's quite good. Not for the passenger side, it's a bit lacking in that aspect, but as it's a hybrid and it's good for the environment and for our pocket too, because they've got a good economy in the fuel section. So that's it about the new CHR hybrid. And if you like my video, please
subscribe to my channel, and that will give a motivation to me, of course. And please like and share with your friends. Till we see with another video, take good care of yourself and keep your family safe, and of course yourself. Okay, bye bye. Till we see, take good care. Thank you.